want you to think about it for a moment. It could have been me. It should have been me. It would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it could have been me. It should have been me. It would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it could have been me. It should have been me. It would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it should have been me. It should have been me. It would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it could have been me. It should have been me. It would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it could have been me. It should have been me.
Nobody has to tell me. I am blessed and highly favored. Nobody has to tell me. Oh, holy God, eternal Father, thank you. Thank you, hallelujah, for blessing me and favoring me. Lord, bless your people today. Bless hearts today. Soften hearts, oh God. Calm hearts. Give us peace. Oh, give us peace so that we can give peace to others. Lord God, you are everything. Everything you are to us and no one else. Oh, if it wasn't for the blood. If it wasn't for the blood, hallelujah. We are blessed and highly favored. We thank you, O God. We give you glory and praise. We honor you. For you are our God. Hallelujah. Oh, what a mighty God we serve, huh? Yes, a God that we can call on at all times, knowing he is there. A God who tells us what to do. He says, keep your eyes stayed on me. Hallelujah. Keep those eyes stayed on Jesus so you don't go to the left and you don't go off to the right. You'll stay right there. In Christ, steady, holding on to Jesus. Oh, glory to God, and you can praise him. Yes, for you are blessed. Hallelujah. You are blessed and highly favored. Give him glory. Give him praise. Thank him.
No one else. but you. I want no one else, no one else, no one else but you. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, I want you. Help me sing.
Jesus, only you.
I want you, only you, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I want you, Lord Jesus, only you. Ah, I know you want him too. It says in Hebrews 12 and verse 2, it says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross. Oh yes, despising the shame, and is sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Yes, we look to Jesus. We are looking to him today, as we should look to him every minute, every hour, every day. We look to Jesus indeed. Spurgeon says in his meditation on that same verse, he says, looking to Jesus, it is always the Holy Spirit's work to turn our eyes away from self to Jesus. But Satan's work is just the opposite. He is constantly trying to make us look at ourselves instead of Christ. He insinuates, your sins are too great for pardon, and you have no faith. You do not repent enough. You will never be able to continue to the end. You do not have the joy of his children. You have such a wavering hold on Jesus. All these are thoughts about yourself that the enemy brings to you. And we will never find comfort or assurance by looking within ourselves. But the Holy Spirit turns our eyes entirely away from ourselves. He tells us that we are nothing, but that Christ is everything. Remember, therefore, it is not your hold on Christ that saves you. It is Christ and Christ alone. It is not your joy in Christ that saves you. It is Christ and Christ alone. It is not even faith in Christ, although that is the instrument. It is Christ's blood and merits. Therefore, do not look so much to your hand with which you are grasping Christ as to Christ. Do not look in your hope, but to Jesus, the source of your hope. Do not look to your faith, but to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of your faith. We will never find happiness by looking at our prayers, our deeds, or our feelings. It is what Jesus is, not what we are, that gives rest to the soul. If we are to overcome Satan and have peace with God, it must be by looking to Jesus. Keep your eyes simply on him. Let his death, his sufferings, his merits, his glories, his intercession be fresh upon your mind. When you wake in the morning, look to him. When you lie down at night, look to him. Do not let your hopes or fears come between you and Jesus. Follow hard after him, and he will never, never fail you. My hope and yours is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Let Jesus be your all in all. Let him be everything to you. Practice his being everything to you. For there will come a time when men's heart will faint for fear and will be disappointed in themselves and in man. The only one that we look to is Jesus. Oh, keep saying that. Jesus, I look to you. Jesus, I look to you. Jesus, I look to you. And he'll be right there, holding you and looking right back at you, letting you know that you are his. Let him be yours in everything, everything.
He is holy, and we bless his name. Everybody lift up your hands and magnify him now. Come on, speak well of him, speak well of him. Come on, speak well of the Holy One. Speak well of him, the one that we just dedicated our lives to. Come on. We bless you. And I beheld and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne, and the living creatures and the elders, and the number of them was thousands and 10,000s upon 10,000s, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and glory and honor and wisdom and strength. And the four and living creatures had each of them six wings, and they flew one to another, and they ceased not crying, holy, 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 holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, and who is, and who is to come. Tonight we want to duplicate the atmosphere of heaven and cry, holy. Speak well of him. Adore him with the fruit of your lips.
He's a holy God. Holy, holy, holy. He is a holy, righteous, loving God, our Father is. Holy, holy, holy. Oh, hallelujah to you, Father God. Praise to your loving, holy name. Oh, righteous, holy Father, we give you praise. You are worthy to be praised. We thank you, O God, for bringing us through. You are almighty. You are eternal. You, O God, hold all in the palm of your hands. You are the center of everything. You hold us, oh God, and you control it all. Oh Heavenly Father, thank you that we look to you and only to you. You are our God. You are our Father. You are our protector. You, Holy One, keep us, and only you. Only you, oh God, and so we give you praise. We honor you. We call out to you, Lord God, for we know that you are in charge, and there is no other. There is no other God. Hallelujah. Oh, righteous, holy Father, and we call on you at all times, in all places, and especially at this time, O God, in our nation, in our world, in your people, those who are going astray, those who refuse to see and to know and to listen and to respond to your holiness. Lord God Almighty, you are in charge. You are still in charge. You will be still in charge, and there will be nothing that can move you out of the way. We thank you, O God. We thank you for this conscious, holy, honest, sober, outright fear of you. O God, we thank you as we reverence you, as we lift up your holy name. We know, O God, that we can trust you. We know, O God, that we can hold on to you. We know that you will never fail us. We know that you will never leave us. We know, O God, that if we put our trust, and we do, that nothing and no one can move us from you. Settle us, O God. Settle us in ourselves. Settle our hearts. Settle our minds. Make us firm. Let us stand firm in your faith and in your strength. Oh, hallelujah to the Lord our God. We know that our Lord and our God stand supreme. There is no other. No other. Don't give up. Hold on to your faith. Don't give up on Jesus. No matter what is going on, no matter how you feel, no matter what you thought or what you think, and if you have thought wrong and the Lord has appeared and showed how wrong you were, you say you are sorry for not looking to the right or whichever way God was showing you, because he showed us all. But some of us didn't want to hear from God. Even us that are Christians, even those who have faith, we didn't want to hear. We wanted our thing. Oh, God can't do that to us. Oh, but God. Hallelujah. But God, the holy, righteous God who sits in his throne, and he says he will do, and it will be well done. Here's what our God said in Revelation. In Revelation chapter 14, the essence of that chapter is that Babylon is fallen. And here's how the word goes. And John is saying, and he says, "And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on the Mount Zion, and with him 144,000. Having his father's name written in their foreheads. And I heard a voice from heaven, as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of a great thunder. And I heard the voice of harpers harping with their harps. And they sung, as it were, a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders. And no man could learn that song but the 144,000, which were redeemed from the earth. These are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goes. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. And in their mouth was found no guile, for they are without fault before the throne of God. And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on the earth, and to every nation and kindred and tongue and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of waters. And there followed another angel, saying, Babylon is fallen, that great city, because she made all nations drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. And a third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, and receive his mark on his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of these torment ascended up forever and ever. And they have no rest, day nor night, who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receives the mark of his name. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Listen carefully. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Two separate things. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. And I looked, and behold a white cloud, and upon the cloud one sat like unto the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown, and in his hand a sharp sickle. And another angel came out of the temple, crying with a loud voice to him that sat on the cloud, thrust in thy sickle and reap, for the time is come for thee to reign and to reap, for the harvest of the earth is ripe. And he that sat on the cloud thrust in his sickle on the earth, and the earth was reaped. And another angel came out of the temple, which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. And another angel came out from the altar, which had power over fire, and cried with a loud cry to him that had the sharp sickle, saying, thrust in thy sharp sickle, and gather the clusters of the vine of the earth, for her grapes are fully ripe. And the angel thrust in his sickle into the earth, and gathered the vine of the earth, and cast it into the great winepress of the wrath of God. And the winepress was trodden without the city, and blood came out of the winepress, even unto the horse bridles, by the space of 1,600 furlongs. And I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, 7 angels having the 7 last plagues, for in them is filled up the wrath of God. And John continues and says, and I saw, as it were, a sea of glass mingled with fire, and them that had gotten the victory over the beast, and over his image, and over his mark, and over the number of his name, stand on the sea of glass, having the harps of God. And they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are thy works, Lord God Almighty. Just and true are thy ways, thou King of saints. Who shall not fear thee, O Lord, and glorify thy name? For thou only art holy, for all nations shall come and worship before thee. For thy judgments are made manifest. And after that I looked, and behold, a temple of the tabernacle of the testimony in heaven was open. And the 7 angels came out of the temple, having the 7 plagues, clothed in pure and white linen, and having their breasts girded with golden girdles. And one of the 4 beasts gave unto the 7 angels 7 golden vials, full of the wrath of God, who lives for ever and ever. And the temple was filled with smoke from the glory of God and from his power, and no man was able to enter into the temple till the 7 plagues of the 7 angels were fulfilled. Here ends the word of God as I read it today. We need to look to God, as we've been saying. Look to God. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. His word is true and shall soon come to pass. This great prophecy that the angel gave to John. Let us be mindful of God's word. Let us not take it for granted and say, oh, it's too hard to understand, I don't seem to get it. Well, the word of God says that blessed are those who read the prophecy, that is the revelation of Jesus Christ, who he is, what he will do, when and how. Read it. God says there's a blessing in it for you if you read it, and when you hear it. God wants you to know what He is about to do. Read His word. Read His word and give Him all the glory, all the praise. He is all wisdom and He is all knowledge. Give God the glory, for He is your God. Lift up His holy name and give Him praise.
You are the hope of my nation. You're the light of my world. You are the hope of my nation. You're the light of my world. They say we're living in a dark world, but there's a light shining in my soul. They say
There is someone who paid the cost for your life.
It's Jesus Christ.
So you don't need all these things
to make you feel like you're gonna make it.
You've got the Son within. Put your trust in Him.
I am free. Oh, thank you, Minister Straker, for downloading that song for me. Oh, how precious. And just the right time to play it. Hallelujah. We give God the glory and the praise. For we are free. Hallelujah. We are one in Him. And so we are free. Jesus is freedom. Jesus is freedom. And if you're in Him, you are free. Hallelujah. Nothing can hold you. You know, the word disappoint keeps coming into my spirit. Don't be disappointed. Don't be disappointed. Oh, for Jesus Christ is yours. He has gone to prepare a place for you, that where He is, you and I will be there too. So don't be disappointed. Don't be in perplexion. Don't be distraught. Oh, I know. Saying don't be, well, you have to make up your mind and look to Jesus, for you are free. I'm going to read the last chapter in Revelation before we leave. It's in my spirit that I should and I will. So here it is. Revelations chapter 22. We must know, oh, how the outcome is. And it's stated at the end of the book. Hallelujah. And so here it is. And He showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. In the midst of the street of it, and on either side of the river, was there the tree of life, which bare 12 manner of fruits, and yielded her fruit every month. And the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and His servants shall serve Him. What shall His servants do? His servants shall serve Him. Are you His servant? Well, serve Him even now. And His servants shall serve Him. And they shall see His face, and His name shall be in their foreheads. And there shall be no night there, and they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign for ever and ever. And he said unto me, these sayings are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel to show unto his servants the things which must shortly be done. Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. And I, John, saw these things and heard them. And when I had heard and seen, I fell down to worship before the feet of the angel, which showed me these things. Then saith he, that is the angel, unto me, see thou do it not, for I am thy fellow servant, and of thy brethren the prophets, and of them which keep the sayings of this book. Worship God. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Man is so quick to worship anything but God. But here, the angel who is serving the Lord, who is a servant of the Lord, who is our fellow servant, is saying, worship God. Oh, praise God. And he said unto me, seal not the sayings of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. Now take heed to this verse. It's verse 11. Listen carefully. He that is unjust, let him be unjust still. And he which is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. And Jesus says, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. Oh, hallelujah! For without are dogs, and sorcerers, and whoremongers, and murderers, and idolaters, and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. I, Jesus, have sent mine angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, and the bright and morning star. And the Spirit and the bride say, come. And let him that hear say, come. And let him that is athirst come. And whosoever will let him take the water of life freely. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book, if any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. And if any man shall take away from the words of this book, of this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life, and out of the holy city, and from the things which are written in this book. He which testifieth these things saith, surely I come quickly. Amen. Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Amen. Verse 20 says, He which testified of these things saith, and he that testified of these things is Jesus Christ. And he says, surely I come quickly. Meaning, when all these things begin to happen, it will happen rapidly, instantly, and completely. Jesus says that surely I come quickly. And what do we say? Come quickly, Lord Jesus. Come, for your people wait and are ready for your coming. Amen. Praise the Lord with me. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord with me. Glory in his holy name. Praise him.
Brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. How many of you tonight are going to make a new dedication, that your life be a praise unto God, a sweet smelling savor. Hallelujah. Come on, let's sing it. Oh, to fulfill your holy purpose, to be pleasing, and acceptable
in your sight.
Lord, nothing else can compare to living in your perfect will, so that my life
be a praise unto you.
My life. those hands together and bless him, bless him, bless him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah to the Lord our God. May our life be lived in his perfect will. May we want that. May we want that. May he find us living perfectly unto him. Yes, we can. The Holy Ghost will allow you to. He will help you in all that you do for God. It's not hard. It is definitely not hard. You know, I searched in all my CDs for this song, Oh God, Our Help in Ages Past, and I was unable to find one, any recording on the CD. And so I thought I would read the first verse for us before I go. And this is out of Psalm 90, verse 1, where Moses is speaking to the people. He says, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. And the song, O God, My Help in Ages Past, says, O God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, our shelter from this stormy blast, and our eternal home. The next verse, under the shadow of thy throne, thy saints have dwelt secure. Sufficient is thine arm, O Lord. Sufficient is thine arm alone, and our defense is sure. Before the hills in order stood, or earth received her frame, from everlasting thou art God, to endless years the same. A thousand ages in thy sight are like an evening gone, short as the watch that ends the night before the rising sun. At time like an ever-rolling stream bears all its sons away. They fly, forgotten as a dream dies at the opening day. O God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, for thou our guide, be thou our guide while life shall last, and our eternal home. And I leave you with that prayer and song that you may sing, O God, our help in ages past. And he is our fortress. Yes, he is our strong tower. He is our bulwark, and he will always be there. Nothing can move you if you are in him. If you don't know Jesus, bow your heads and ask him to come in. Say your prayer from your heart and ask him to come into your life. Tell him to come in and save you, for you acknowledge that he is the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And he'll take your sins away, and you'll be a new creature in him, and he'll give you the Holy Spirit to keep you in all of your ways. May the Lord continue to keep us. Keep our mind stayed on Jesus. Keep us in his perfect will. We love the Lord with all of our hearts and souls and minds and wills and all of our strength. And we will love one another in the same way. Trust God. Trust him. Don't doubt him. Stand in his word and assail your enemies. Go forth in Jesus, for he loves you. And so do I. And so until we meet again another day, we ask God to keep you and to keep you in his perfect peace as your mind is stayed on him. All right? May the Lord bless you. I thank you for listening. I thank you for supporting Choice Radio. And I would ask you to please listen to Arise in the Morning with with Minister Straker, and you will have joy all that day. All right? May the Lord bless you. And be encouraged, for the Lord loves you. Bye-bye.